That voice, just so, so sweet. That was Terry Hall with Salad from 1995. The album was Help, and that was Dream a Little Dream. There are so many touching tributes all over the place. Damon Albarn has just posted the most beautiful touching tribute. He simply said, Terry, you meant the world to me. I love you. And just is playing on the keyboards. Thanks for listening to the show. See you tomorrow night. Stand by for some Christmas brass. It is Radio 2 on BBC Sounds app and your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 9 o'clock. This is Claire Runacres. The Health Secretary, Steve Barclay, has urged people to take extra care as ambulance workers in England and Wales go on strike tomorrow. Mr. Barclay described the walkouts as deeply regrettable after talks between the government and health workers' unions failed to reach an agreement. Today, thousands of nurses in England, Wales and Northern Ireland took part in their second strike in less than a week. Our political correspondent, Ione Wells, says some Conservative MPs have called on the government to back down.
The government's attitude towards unions' pay demands was something that the government felt pretty confident about. They were pretty at ease, I think, until recently, that most of the Conservative Party were on their side. I think now we are starting to see some tensions, really, from different ends of the spectrum from the Conservative Party about where the government goes next on this, because ultimately, if there is no conclusion that is reached, we are just going to see more and more strikes into the new year.
Train drivers are to stage a fresh strike early in the new year after members of the ASLEF union voted in favour of more industrial action in the long-running dispute about pay. More than 12,000 drivers will walk out at 15 companies on the 5th of January. The RMT union is already planning 4 days of action that week. The Taliban government in Afghanistan are banning women from going to university and other places of higher education. The move is expected to take effect immediately. The US State Department spokesman Ned Price said it would further alienate Afghanistan's rulers from the international community.
The Taliban have permanently sentenced Afghan women to a darker and more barren future without opportunity. No country can thrive when half of its population is arbitrarily held back. Education is an internationally recognized human right, and it is essential to Afghanistan's economic growth and its stability.
The Defense Secretary, Ben Wallace, says Russia intends to provide Iran with advanced military components in return for Tehran having supplied hundreds of kamikaze drones, which have been used by Moscow to attack civilian infrastructure in Ukraine. Speaking in the Commons, Mr. Wallace said Russia's enablers must be held to account.
In return for having supplied more than 300 kamikaze drones, Russia now intends to provide Iran with advanced military components, undermining both Middle East and international security. We must expose that deal. Fact, I have just now.
A coroner in West Sussex has concluded that 11 men were unlawfully killed when a plane performing at the Shoreham Air Show in 2015 crashed onto a dual carriageway. The inquest found the plane had come down on the A27 because of errors by the pilot Andy Hill. He was acquitted of gross negligence manslaughter at a criminal trial in 2019. And Argentina's World Cup team have been forced to cut short an open-top bus tour of the country's capital, Buenos Aires, because of massive crowds. Around 4 million people are estimated to have poured onto the streets to welcome the players home. The team completed their journey by helicopter. BBC News, it's 3 minutes past nine. BBC
Radio 2. Hi, I'm James Morrison, and this is A Top Brass Christmas. All the amazing brass music you'd expect from the show, but with a festive feel. Starting with our old friend, Good King Kenton?